फ्रेंड्स, आई एम प्रशांत कुमार. वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल सोशियो क्रिटिक. सब्सक्राइब द चैनल एंड हिट द बेल आइकॉन, यू विल गेट नेक्स्ट लेसन्स. वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट इंस्टेंट सोशल साइंस. नाउ लेट अस डिस्कस अबाउट जियोग्राफी, द फोर्थ लेसन ऑफ द जियोग्राफी, इंडियन सॉइल्स. सो सॉइल, व्हाट इज सॉइल? लेट अस सी दैट. Meaning and importance. What is soil? The thin surface layer of the earth comprising of closely intermixed in mineral and organic substances. It is a thin layer over the surface of the earth which is having closely intermixed mineral and organic substances. And India is an agricultural country. Agriculture is the main occupation of the people of India. So agricultural production is basically dependent on the fertility of the soil. So soil is very important one. And the soil formation of India, which related to the parent rock, relief, climate and natural vegetation. So that depends on these four. And which are the types of soil we have in India? So there are six types of soils we have in India. They are alluvial soil, black soil, red soil, laterite soil, desert soil, mountain soil. So like the six types, let us discuss about each and every soil. First, alluvial soil. See, alluvial soil which is having alluvium, soil that composed of alluvium. What is alluvium? So that alluvium is the sediments brought by the rivers and settled there, formed from the sediments deposited by the rivers and sea waves. So that is very fertile soil, very useful for agriculture. And this alluvial soil cover the area of 15 lakh square kilometer. 15 lakh kilometer square area is covered. And in this alluvial soil, main crops which is possible to grow, they are wheat, paddy, sugarcane, cotton, jute, potato and vegetables. So most of the crops it is possible to grow. And in the regional language, in the local language, they call the alluvial soil different types. The newer alluvial soil, the fine and newer, the fresh one, recently deposited, that one is called as kadar. And coarse gravel and older alluvium is called as bangar. So the difference in the regional language they call like this. So this is about alluvial soil. Next, black soil. Black soil is also called as a ragar soil or black cotton soil. So this soil is suitable for the cotton crop. That's why it is called as black cotton soil. And which is derived from the basalt rock. That's what is black in color. Dark gray to black with high clay content. So because of the clay content here, which retain moisture, highly retentive of moisture and extremely compact, which will retain moisture in it, that's why dry farming is possible here. Yeah, why dry farming is suitable for black soil? Because it is having fine clay particle. These fine clay particles are helpful to retain water in it, moisture in it. The crops which are grown here are mainly cotton soil, that's why cotton is a common crop, sugarcane, jowar, maize, pulses, wheat and chilies. And these black soils found in the Deccan Basalt Trap region. Deccan Basalt Trap. What is the Deccan Trap? The regions which are having black soil is called as a Deccan Trap, Deccan Basalt Trap. So question may come, that's why. And this black soil occupy about 5.46 lakh square kilometer area. That much area is having this one. And the peninsula plate at the center, the most part of that part, and Gujarat, southern jaw, there it is having black soil. Okay, next, red soil. Red soil is formed from the weathering of granite gneiss and crystalline rocks. So weathering of these rocks, this red soil is formed. As they are more sandy and less clayey, do not retain moisture in it. Red soil do not retain moisture, so dry farming not possible here. And cover about 5.2 lakh square kilometer area. And this red soil is found in southern Karnataka, South Karnataka, Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, Odisha, Kerala, Goa, Bihar, Uttar Pradesh, Assam, Manipur, Nagaland, West Bengal, etc. These areas we can see red soil, red in color. Ferrous oxide is there, that's why it is red in color. Crops, which are the crops suitable for this? This red soil is suitable for which crops? Ragi, millets, groundnuts, tobacco, and potato. These are the crops suitable for this. Next, laterite soil. I think many students, they don't know the laterite soil, which one. The coastal Karnataka area, they know very well about this, especially South Kerala, Kerala, etc. Kerala also they know, South Kerala, Udupi, they know. They construct houses from this soil. The soil is a hard one. They cut it into the pieces like this, cake pieces. And they construct the houses from this one. The laterite soil is formed in tropical areas with high temperature and heavy rainfall. And this laterite soil cover about 2.48 lakh square kilometers. And this is formed in Western Ghats, Eastern Ghats, Chota Nagpur Plate, Meghalaya, Meghalaya Plate, Rajmahal Hills, Vindhya and Satpura Mountains. They are leached soil and not fertile. It is not fertile soil. Not suitable for the especially food crops, etc. It is very unfertile, actually, not that much fertile. Cashew we can grow in the hilly region of South Kerala, Kerala, etc. You can see that. Rubber, tea, coffee, and rarely paddy. Yeah, these are the main crops here. And this looks like this. Yeah, this is about laterite soil. Next, desert soil. I don't have to explain about desert soil. Desert means sand, you know that. Fairly friable, high content of soluble salt. It is sandy and low in moisture and humus. It is not fertile, not suitable to grow the crop. Which occupy about 1.42 lakh square kilometers. Mainly in India, it is found in Rajasthan, southern Haryana, some parts of Punjab and northern Gujarat. And the crops, only few crops, some crops can be grown where irrigation is available. In the border areas of desert, especially Thar deserts of Rajasthan, we have. And in the border areas, wherever the irrigation is possible, date, palm, etc., we can grow. It is possible. So this is about desert soil. Mountain soil. Mountain soil is formed due to the decomposition of organic matter. So, because of the decomposition of organic matter, it is rich in humus and it is fertile. And found on the slopes of mountains and hills covered by forest. And that plants, leaf and branches, etc. will fall and decompose. And animals which die, which decompose there. So totally it becomes fertile. These are found, mountain soils are found in Jammu and Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, Manipur, and along the Western Ghats. So it is found. This cover about 2.85 lakh square kilometer. Yeah. So this is about mountain soil. Okay, we discussed about the six types of soil. Now, we have discussed about soil erosion. What is soil erosion? removal of topsoil by natural agents like river, glaciers, winds, etc. Last year you know that flood came or landslides happened. Every year it is common. At that time, removal of topsoil, losing of fertility of the outer soil, that is soil erosion. What are the causes for the soil erosion? Deforestation, cutting the trees. As a result, soil become loose and soil erosion common. Overgrazing, animals graze more and more, the grass which is holding the soil, which becomes loose and soil erosion common. Shifting cultivation, you know, clearing the one area of the forest and cultivate. After the losing the fertility of the soil, they clear another part of the forest and start cultivating. Like that, cutting the trees there, clearing the forest, that's why shifting cultivation is also causes soil erosion. Faulty method of cultivation, wrong method of cultivation, using more water irrigation, more, and or without making soil testing, simply pouring chemical fertilizers, by that soil become waste and it lose its fertility. So there is a faulty methods of scientific method we have to do, faulty methods of cultivation and use of top soil for making bricks, tiles, etc. If you make that topper soil only, it is a fertile soil, not inner soil, which will go away. These are the causes for soil erosion. What are the effects of soil erosion? Loss of soil fertility and fall in agricultural productivity. In agricultural productivity, automatically it comes down because fertility is very important one. And if you want to make it fertile, we have to pour more and more fertilizers. Then it becomes costly. Accumulation of silt in riverbeds leads to flood. The loose soil which flow with rainwater and settle in the riverbed, the capacity to hold the water in the river, it reduces and results in flood. Change of course of river. River change its course because of the soil erosion. And because silt accumulates, no, that's why. Reduction of capacity of the reservoirs. Reservoirs in the dam, backwater, their capacity reduces because silt accumulates there. And decrease in the groundwater level and soil moisture. Groundwater level decreases because these trees, forests, etc., that helps to sink water into the earth, but not there, these roots which will die and lose soil, which will erode, and soil moisture also will not be there. Vegetation dries up, drought increases because of soil erosion. Fertility not there, that's so vegetation will dry up and drought increases. Economy as a whole suffers a great setback. Because of loss of fertility, production reduces, whole economy gets great setback. These are the effects of soil erosion. Can we conserve the soil? Is possible? How to conserve the soil? Protection of soil from erosion and preservation of fertility of the soil. You have to protect the soil from erosion. And prevention, preservation of fertility of the soil is called as conservation of soil. What is conservation of soil? This one. And how? Afforestation and reforestation. You have to grow more and more trees. By that it is possible to hold the soil tightly. Controlled overgrazing. Overgrazing is a cause for this soil erosion. We have to control that. Contour farming is this type of farming. See here, steps they will make. They will make the steps here on the slope areas. By that, speed of the flow of the water reduces. And here you can make contour farming, and it helps and to avoid soil erosion. Construction of check dams. By constructing check dams, the flow of the river water reduces, speed reduces. As a result, when speed reduces, soil erosion also reduces. Contour bending and gully control and bench terracing. See here, contour bending, etc. See the terrace forming like this, a slope in the beginning like this, and we have to cut the slope area, and like this we have to make the soil, water which fall here sink into the earth. So like this we have to make terrace like this. So gully control, bench terracing, so all these same type, so different names actually, same type we have to make like this, and we have to control. So main three questions: what are the causes for soil erosion, what are the effects of soil erosion, how to conserve soil, and here one more question comes, that is why should we conserve the soil. At that time commonly students, they will make the mistake of writing conservation of soil, not that one. We have to write the effects of soil erosion. Okay, so we have to protect the soil, and we have to protect the fertility of the soil, and let us preserve our forests and soil. Thank you.